Morning standard 7. Today we are going to discuss chapter number 5, Tom's treasure hunt. Treasure, you know, treasure means wealth, something hidden. Okay, Tom's treasure hunt. Before going to start this chapter, let's warm up a little. The following is a delightful excerpt from Mark Twain's novel The Adventure of Tom Sawyer, about two naughty boys, Tom and Huck, how they find treasure. In this story, we came to know the two boys called Tom and Huck, how did they find the treasure which was hidden, okay, by someone. If you come to know about this, about some hidden treasure, will you discuss it with somebody or will you go in search of that treasure alone? Just think about it. Let's begin. The sun set and the two boys were still waiting. They were after Red Joe's treasure. Actually, the two boys were running or finding the treasure after Red Joe. The two boys were after Red Joe's treasure. Here, the two boys were running behind the Red Joe's treasure. Would Joe wake up before morning and would they have to stay there all night? About an hour after sunset, Red Joe woke up. He kicked his companion hard. Okay, what? In the morning, after sunset, Red Joe woke up. He kicked his companion. Companion means here friend, hard. Come on, he said. We must get out of here at once. We must hide the money before we go. We can't carry it around with us. Actually, Red Joe kicked his companion to wake up and he said, we must go out with the treasure. It was not a safer place. Okay. Then the two boys clearly heard the words money and hide. Their eyes began to shine. Actually, the two boys were there where Red Joe and his companion were there. Okay. And the two boys were clearly hearing all the word they spoke. Okay. I told you, Tom whispered to Huck, we have come to the right place. They watched the men throw the cracks in the floor. Actually, Tom and Huck were watching what the two men were doing, okay, through the cracks of the building. Okay, the two men lifted up a heavy stone. What they saw? The two men lifted up a heavy stone. Red Joe began digging a hole with his knife till it struck something hard. Okay, struck means hit something with force. Okay, he digging the floor of the building to hide his treasure. To find his treasure, okay, it's a box, help me pull it out. The two pulled up the box. Finally, Red Joe and his friend found their money or a box, okay. They pulled up the box. It contained gold coins. What was there in the box? Simply the gold coins, okay. It was full of gold coins. Murrell's men used to come here, Red Joe's companion said. At that time, Red Joe's friend said, Murrell's men used to come here. Okay. It is theirs. And now it is ours, said Red Joe, in order to bury it safely. He needed a spade. Spade, you know, spade is a tool used for digging. Okay. His eyes fall on two spades. How did those spades get here? He asked. There was some fresh soil on them. Actually, they saw two spades were there and there were some soil, fresh soil, sticked on the spade. Somebody has been here lately. No, we won't bury the gold here. Well, it take it to my place. They have decided that they have decided to take their treasure or box to their place. Okay. Number two, under the cross. Cross, you know, here cross is a word. Cross is a thing which is commonly found in the church. Okay. Number two, under the cross. That's the safest place, said Job. But I would first like to find out those two boys we saw yesterday. They may be here today. Actually, Joe said, number two under the cross was the safest place to keep their treasure. Okay. But he would like to find out the boys, those who were listening their words. Okay. Or those who were, they may be here today. Begin to climb their stairs. The boy grew frightened. Frightened means got feared. They simply lay there still, waiting for death. The footsteps were very near now. The boys almost stopped breathing. Okay? As Red Joe and his friend come towards the boys, those who were hiding in a place, the two boys took a deep breath with fear. Okay? Crash, a stair broke under Joe and he fell to the floor. Okay? Come on, said the other man. You will break your neck if you go up those stairs again. Let's go out of here. And they went away with treasure. And finally, they leave the building with their treasure. The boy climbed down the stairs. They have taken the treasure to number two. Where's that hawk? Tom asked to hawk. Okay. Where's that? That means where the number two? Where the two men had buried their treasure? I don't know. We will have to find out. Was hawk's answer. Hawk answered simply, I don't know. We will have to find out where they had buried their treasure. Next morning, what happened? Next morning, Tom and Huck started their search again. Do you think it's the number of a room? Room number two in some inn. In some inn means, I-N, inn means a small hotel. Okay. Actually, they thought that it must be a room number two in a small hotel. Okay. There were only two inns in town. There were only two small hotels in town. The search at the first inn bore no fruit. That means when they had gone to the first hotel and find the treasure, they got nothing. Okay. At Hopkins Inn, Fred Miller told them that number two room at his inn was a strange room. When they got to the Hopkins Inn, after finding nothing in the first hotel, okay, Fred Miller gives some information that his room number two was a strange room. It was occupied by a mysterious person. It was occupied by a mysterious person, means suspicious person, who liked to drink, sing, and keep shut. Red Joe drinks a lot, Huck said to Tom. Is Huck knew that Red Joe has a drunker. Red Joe was a drunker. The back door of that room was in a side street. They collected all the old keys. The next moonless night, Tom made his way to the back door of the room number two. He went into the hotel room number two, but soon ran out in panic, got hurt. Okay. In old bran means here, bran is a large building for keeping animals and grains. Here simply a big building, okay, or large building. At the end of the village, Tom said, "Oh, Hawk, it was terrible. I turned the knob and the door opened. Okay? Then I went in and told on Joe's hand." Tom said, when I went into the big building or large building, I suddenly put my foot on Red Joe's hand. Okay? He was lying on the floor, drunk. All right, we will keep a watch, and when Joe goes out, actually they were waiting for Joe's departure. Okay? We shall get hold of the box of treasure, said Hawk. Many days passed. One evening, the two boys had a long walk together. Red Joe's friend is dead, Hawk told Tom. Many days passed. Red Joe's friend was dead. And this information Hawk gave Tom. They found him in the river. They found him. Him means here Red Joe's friend's body was found by them in the river. Perhaps Joe killed him. They thought that perhaps Joe killed him and then threw his body into the river. Red Joe also met with a terrible death. He used to hide in a cave after the death of his friend. He used to hide himself in a cave. The judge ordered the cave to be closed with an iron door. But 3 days later, he learned that Joe was inside. The door was opened. There lay Red Joe dead. What happened? After the death of Red Joe's friend, Red Joe used to hide himself in a cave. When the judge used to hide himself in a cave, suddenly the judge of the city ordered that the cave should be shut with an iron door. Okay? And he did it. And then Red Joe died inside the cave. And when the judge came to know that Red Joe was inside the cave, he opened the gate, and so Red Joe was dead. Tom and Hawk were not sorry about Joe. Now their fear was gone, because Joe and his friend were dead. They had looked for the treasure in the room number 2, but all in vain. Here all in vain means producing no result. He found nothing in room number 2. They hoped to find it in the cave. That afternoon, they went down the river in a boat. They saw a hole in the rock on the other side of the river. They lit their candles and walked to the other side of the cave. They lit their candle and walked along a narrow passage. Passage means here way. Passage means way, rasta. Okay. Look, Huck, Tom pointed. There is the cross. The money must be there. They moved on and on. There is the big rock. Tom found a matchstick there. Somebody had lit the candle there. Actually, when Tom found a matchstick near the hole or near the passage or near the cave or near the rock, he confirmed that somebody had lighted a candle there. The boys started digging and struck a box. They pulled it up and broke it open. It was full of gold coins. Madly they began to laugh, sing and dance. They rode back in triumph. Triumph means they rode back in triumph to the village carrying bag full of gold. Here, triumph means great achievement or success. They were very much happy with their success and the mission was accomplished. The mission was accomplished means the mission was success or completed. This much, the question answer will be sent soon. Thank you.